Hey YouTube. So I was doing some searching around the other day and I was trying to get a pattern for some American black ducks, fully flocked decoys, but couldn't manage to find anything. So I figured I would put together a little video. I'm improvising as we go here, so bear with me. But I think they're gonna turn out pretty good. First things first, just wanna give you a quick idea here. I just created little tracks out of old 2x4s, 2x3s, so they could line these wet flocked decoys up, let them dry. Gonna give you a quick run through of what I've got here. I've got some old greenhead gear mallard decoys. These have been sanded down fully. Doesn't quite look like it, but they were pretty beat up to begin with. But gave them a good sanding. See, this mallard actually has a flocked head already. These three are actually mallards as well. I mean, drake mallards. If you're working with a decoy that has a flocked head to begin with, I found it more helpful instead of sanding the head to take a wire brush. I got a little wire brush that I put in the electric drill. Kind of hit the head with a wire brush. If you're not too familiar with dealing with a flocked head, it's not gonna sand too well. Wire brush is probably a better bet to get those prepped and ready for paint. Also, if they're dirty, you're gonna obviously wanna clean them off before you start this whole process. You don't want any dirt, grime, or anything like that on them. It's gonna screw with your paint adhesion. I've also got some Rust-Oleum flat black paint. That's gonna be my glue. I think it's pretty widely accepted as the preferred glue for flocking. Got my thinner, some brushes. I've got my bulk flocking here. I think I bought this on eBay years ago. I actually used it to do some scoters and eiders, but this will work perfectly for black ducks. Shockingly, I know. I've also got my flocking container here. I've got my strainer that I'm going to use to apply my flocking. It's also filled with a bunch of flocking. You definitely want one of these containers because they will they'll help you keep your flocking, reuse it over and over. If you don't use one of these things, if you just do it outside or something, you're going to end up going through a ton of flocking. And this stuff can get expensive, so definitely want to contain it in something like this. I think this is an old litter box for my mom's cats, who are all dead now, so I don't think they'll mind. I think that's about it. Oh, I've also got some homemade motion ducks here that I just flocked the heads on. I don't know if you guys have ever seen those, but basically cut the back open and throw a weasel ball in there. I got weasel balls over there. Throw a weasel ball inside a sock. Stick it in that decoy there. This thing kind of opens up nicely. Not gonna do it now, show you, but opens up, throw the weasel ball in there, turn it on, and it creates a pretty good ripple. There's plenty of tutorials out there on how to make those guys. But all right, here's a few of the black ducks that I've got going already. They're a little wet. They look a little shiny. As they dry, that paint's gonna flatten out. Get nice and flat. All right, I think I'm gonna move right into the flocking process. See you guys in a second. All right, so I'm gonna get the show on the road here with this decoy. So if you've ever painted a room or anything like that, you probably know that you're supposed to cut in your corners. You basically want to do the detail work before you really start applying your paint with a roller or bigger brush or whatever. I'm going to use a similar process here on this decoy. I've got this artist's, I think it's a 3/4 inch brush. I'm going to use that to do the head. I'm going to get around the bill here, get in this crevice here. Might do a little work on the tail with it too. That's gonna allow me to, when I switch to my bigger brush, I'm not gonna basically be going near the bill or any of the spots where I don't want a flock. I am gonna do the eye. I'm gonna paint the eye on this decoy. Black duck, I'm not really too concerned about it. If I was doing a mallard or something like that, I'd try to leave the eye alone. Not get any flocking on there. So without further ado, I'm not gonna show you guys how to paint the whole decoy. I'm sure you can figure that out on your own, but I'll give you a start here, show you how to get things rolling, and then we'll probably cut straight to the flocking. With this flocking, when you have a flock head like this, it's gonna take a lot of paint. So don't be afraid to be liberal with it. Like I said, start around the detailed areas where you're up against somewhere where you don't want there to be any flocking. Any areas that are flocked, I know I just said this, but any areas that are flocked are going to take a ton of paint. So don't be shy. I like to get any tighter areas too with this smaller brush. Tends to do a much better job than the big brush. Tend to get paint everywhere if I try to do it with the big brush. Just so you guys know, this is gonna be a multi-part video, so this one coat of flocking that I'm going to show you here is by no means the end of this. I'm going to apply a lot more detail and whatnot as this video goes on. If you use a bigger brush on these kind of grooved areas, it tends to leave accumulations of paint, and gets a little messy. That said, a little thicker painting coating of paint, the flocking kind of holds it together. So try not to have any drips, but don't be afraid of a nice thick coat. Alright, I know I said I wasn't going to show you painting the whole decoy, but I think I am, because I don't want to stop now. Don't be afraid of that, the bottom of the decoy either. Obviously ducks aren't gonna see that, hopefully, unless you're shooting up your decoys or something. is probably a little boring, but it is what it is. You'll be plenty bored by yourself probably doing this. Although maybe you'll enjoy it. Some of us, some people like myself, kind of find it relaxing. All right, I think we're just about covered there. Figures I'm dripping paint all over the place right at the end. All right, I'm gonna pause this now and move on to the, move you over to the flocking station. All right, so this is real easy. We're just gonna take our strainer here that we got full flocking. We're just gonna shake it over the decoy until we see pretty much no more shine on the decoy anywhere. I highly, highly recommend wearing a face mask when you do this. Oh, hold on, I'm missing spots of paint already. Rushed it for you guys. So like I said, I highly recommend a mask or a ventilator or something for this step. Also, you're gonna, we're actually in the middle of a nor'easter right now. You're not gonna want to do this outside if there's any wind. I mean, this is really ideally an indoor project because your flocking is gonna fly all over the place and you're gonna lose half of it to the wind. So, without further ado here, I'm going to show you how we do this. It's real simple. Just shake your flocking. And there's a million YouTube videos out there describing this process. So I'm sure if you're here, you've probably seen those videos before. What I like to do is I like to get a real thick coat on here. That kind of assures me that I'm not gonna miss any spots before I shake this off. This tends to be a messy process too, so if you want to wear some gloves or something like that, by all means, it's probably a good idea. I don't, because quite frankly, I don't care if I'm covered in paint. Although you definitely will care if you're breathing in this flocking. You're gonna have black boogers for the next 5 days. I mean, if you like black boogers, that's fine. But it's a real weird feeling inside your nose. Probably too much information there, but All right, so that looks like we're nice and covered there. Just gonna give it a few whacks, shake it around a little bit, get that flocking, the excess flocking off of there. Alrighty, we're gonna come over here. I'm just gonna slide this decoy right in between those two pieces of scrap wood. Grab it by the bill and kind of just slide it down here. And there we have it. Until the next step. All right, so as you can see, I've got my ducks in a row here. Getting dry. Something I forgot to mention in the beginning of this video is that I'm actually going to do two coats of this flocking. For anyone who's ever flocked decoys before, you probably know that two coats is far superior to one. That first coat tends to have some paint shining through and that kind of thing. That second coat really finishes the decoy off nice. So I'm going to let these dry for 24 hours per the directions on the can of Rust-Oleum. Kind of sucks. I wish I could do two coats today, but I'm going to let them dry for 24 hours. I'm going to recoat them tomorrow, apply a second coat of flocking, and then I will, in 2 days, start the process of applying the finishing touches to these decoys, and I will see you guys then. Okay, so I know I said I was gonna improvise throughout this process. After I finished this first coat of flocking, I sat down and kind of thought about what my next step would be. And my original plan was to just do a full second coat of black flocking. As I thought about it, I realized that for those of you that know what an American black duck looks like, you know that they have a grayish head with black markings. I realized that if I tried to spray this head grayish, anything that I missed would get the body covered with that grayish paint. So I went back to the drawing board real quick. And I tried something that I haven't tried before. I took some white flocking and some black flocking, 4 parts of the white, 2 parts of the black, mixed them together in this bag, then took that, put it in my sifter, sifted it into the bucket, and then poured it back into the bag. Sifting them together, by the way, is a pretty important step if you're gonna combine these colors, it seems like. I ended up with a lot of like white and black clumps that didn't go through the sifter. So if you didn't sift them, then you're gonna end up with some straight white, straight black clumps in there. But this looked pretty good. You really can't tell that it's white and black combined. Like if I bought this by itself, I'd say yeah, that's gray flocking. So what I'm gonna do is instead of flocking the head black, I'm gonna flock it this gray color. And then I'll spray my black markings on there, and that way that black will blend right in with the black decoy instead of coloring the thing gray. Alright, so I'll see you when I'm done with that process. Alright guys, so I'm back. I've flocked the heads on these. Probably can't tell from the video, but I started with this one. It's actually a little bit darker than the rest of them. This was my test subject here. After I did this one, I added another part and a half of white flocking. So I think the final ratio was like 5.5 to 6 parts of white. Yeah, that's right. Sorry. Beer's getting to me. 5.5 to 6 parts of white to 2 parts of black flocking to create this this gray color for the head. I think they look pretty good. I'm still gonna touch them up and add that black accent to them. But they look pretty good for now. The pain in the butt is that when you do these heads like this, when you do them separate from the body, it's gonna add an extra day to your project. So I gotta give these heads a day to dry, then I'm gonna flock the bodies, give those a day to dry, and then come back and finish everything up. So at this point, I think they look good, but definitely more to come. I will see you guys tomorrow. All right, guys, so I'm back here. I've got two coats of the flocking on the body. I got the gray head here. They're looking pretty good at this point, to be honest. I mean, it's a little dirty, but clean that off. They still need a little bit more, which I'm gonna get done with an airbrush. I realize that most of you probably don't have an airbrush. This can pretty easily be done with a spray can, or you can do it by hand. If you're gonna use a spray can, I'd probably recommend using some sort of stencil or something like that to get this done, but you can do it by hand. I don't know how this is going to turn out. I haven't used the airbrush in probably 5 years, so we'll see. Give me a couple minutes, I'll set you up and I'll show you what I'm doing. All right, so what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to add a little detail with the airbrush. I should preface this by saying I am by no means an artist, so I have no idea how these are gonna turn out, but I'm hoping the compressor doesn't come on while I'm painting these and screw the video up, but if it does, so be it. I'm gonna have to block your ears for a little bit. So all I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna add a quick little line. Just a little line in here. Gonna pop the head, top of the head. And that's pretty much it. Maybe cut in the neck a little bit. But that's about it right there. I think that looks pretty good. And I'll get back to you guys when I finish up the bills. All right, guys, so I've got the three drakes I'm going to do, I've got them finished up. What I did was I went to Home Depot and I grabbed some paint samples. Got the yellow here for the drakes. I got this olive here for the hens. The olive was actually on clearance for 50 cents, so must have been a screw-up or something. But I love a good deal. If it doesn't turn out right, then I guess I'll just sand them down and paint them with something else. I think this is a latex-based paint, but I'm not too worried about it with the bills, you know. Worst case scenario, I'll just hit them again with the paint if it starts to peel or something. But I sanded down the bills real good. I've already got the drakes painted up. The yellow's possibly a little too yellow, but I don't think the black ducks are gonna take out their color palette when they're decoying, so should work. And I'll just give you a quick little look at what I'm doing here to get these bills painted. All right, so I'm sure you guys can figure out how to do this on your own, but
I'll show you just for the sake of completing the whole decoy on camera. Alright, so I got these painted up nice olive color. Really looks, for some reason, looks yellow in the video, but it's really an olive color. But so these hen black ducks have some black markings, like usually on the top of the bill and then the front, kind of like a mottled, hazy black looking. So I'll probably do one more coat of the olive and then hit it with the airbrush again to give it those black markings. And we'll call it a day. All right, so here's the finished product. I actually, you know, the yellow on the Drake bill was a little too flashy, so I actually mixed in some of the olive for the hen bill with the yellow and added a last coat of this kind of dulled down yellow coat for the Drake's bill. But this is about it. You know, I think they look pretty good. I'll definitely be shooting some black ducks over them this fall. Let me know what you guys think. I'm gonna end the video here. You know, I'm probably gonna add a little black and black markings in here. But I'm not gonna throw it on the video. Maybe I'll throw a picture on at the end, who knows? Probably not. Pretty much had enough of filming this stuff, but no offense to you guys, but so yeah, let me know what you guys think. Questions, comments are always appreciated. Suggestions, those are appreciated as well. If you guys do your own black ducks or do your own flocking or whatever, let me know what you think. I appreciate you guys watching. Thanks.